Listening Library presents Save the Gorillas by Anita Sanchez and Chelsea Clinton. Read for you by Marisha Tapera. With the letter written and read by Chelsea Clinton.
Dear reader, when I was around your age, my favorite animals were dinosaurs and elephants. I wanted to know everything I could about triceratopses, stegosauruses, and other dinosaurs that had roamed our Earth millions of years ago. Elephants, though, captured my curiosity and my heart. The more I learned about the largest animals on land today, the more I wanted to do to help keep them and other endangered species safe forever. So I joined organizations working around the world to support endangered species and went to our local zoo to learn more about conservation efforts close to home, thanks to my parents and grandparents. I tried to learn as much as I could about how we can ensure animals and plants don't go extinct like the dinosaurs, especially since it's the choices that we're making that pose the greatest threat to their lives today. The choices we make don't have to be huge to make a real difference. When I was in elementary school, I used to cut up the plastic rings around 6 packs of soda, glue them to brightly colored construction paper, purple was my favorite, and hand them out to whomever would take one in a one-girl campaign to raise awareness about the dangers the plastic 6-pack rings pose to marine wildlife around the world. I learned about that from a book, 50 Simple Things Kids Can Do to Save the Earth, which helped me understand that you're never too young to make a difference and that we all can change the world. I hope that this book will inform and inspire you to help save this and other endangered species. There are tens of thousands of species that are currently under threat, with more added every year. We have the power to save those species, and with your help, we can. Sincerely, Chelsea Clinton.
1. Our cousins in the rainforest. What happens if you tickle a gorilla? And would you dare to try? Gorillas are big animals that can be really, really scary. They have huge fangs, enormous muscles, and can weigh over 400 pounds. Sometimes a male gorilla will pound his chest and let out a terrifying roar. Their massive arms are strong enough to tear down trees and bend iron bars. Who wouldn't be scared? But it turns out that gorillas aren't as dangerous as they look. They don't eat people. In fact, for the most part, they don't eat meat at all, just plants. Gorillas can be gentle friends and tender, loving parents. And they really like to laugh. Scientists used to think that humans were the only species that could laugh. But research has shown that other kinds of animals can laugh too. Gorillas make sounds that are very similar to the sounds people make when they're having fun. They snort, giggle, and chuckle when they're tickled by playmates or when one of their brothers or sisters is chasing them playfully. Humans and gorillas may look different on the outside. After all, gorillas are covered with fur, while we have thick hair on only a few places on our bodies. But underneath all that fur, gorillas are more like humans than you might first think. Humans and gorillas are both primates, a group of mammals that includes monkeys, apes, and lemurs. Gorillas are some of our closest relatives. Both people and gorillas have 5 digits, fingers or toes, on each arm and leg. We both have eyes that look straight ahead. Adult humans have the same number of teeth as adult gorillas, 32. And unlike most mammals, neither humans nor gorillas have tails. Gorilla bones, hearts, livers, and kidneys all look a lot like ours, just bigger. But of course, there are a lot of ways we're different from gorillas, too. One difference is in numbers. There are more than 7 billion human beings on the planet. there are only about 100,000 gorillas. Another big difference is our habitat. Human beings live all over the planet, in every kind of place you can imagine. Tropical islands, frozen tundra, dry deserts, and swampy wetlands. Gorillas live only in Central Africa, in a region near the equator called the Congo Basin. And they live only in one kind of place, the misty, moist, green habitat called a rainforest. A forest for gorillas. Rainforests are ancient environments. They existed on our planets millions of years ago, and in some places, they really haven't changed much over time. Rainforests have closely packed trees, forming a leafy roof that blocks the sun and keeps the ground damp and shady. Tall trees are draped with vines and flowering orchids, while grasses and shrubs grow underneath. The Congo rainforest has more than 10,000 different kinds of plants. Since gorillas are plant eaters, the rainforest is like a giant supermarket filled with the foods they need. The rainforest stretches through many countries, including Cameroon, Gabon, Central African Republic, Democratic Republic of the Congo, DRC, Republic of the Congo, Equatorial Guinea, Rwanda, Uganda, and Nigeria. It's home to countless different kinds of living things: birds, bats, butterflies, fungi, fish, ferns, and more. There are hundreds of species of mammals, including chimpanzees, forest elephants, hippos, and leopards. And it's the only place in the world where gorillas live wild and free. Not all parts of this giant forest are the same. If you visited the swampy lowlands of Gabon, you'd be hot and sweaty. But if you climbed up the steep mountains in Rwanda, you might shiver with cold. These mountains are so high that the temperatures are often chilly, and damp mists drift through the trees. Scientists have identified two different species of gorillas which don't interbreed: eastern gorillas and western gorillas. These two species live about 500 miles apart, on opposite sides of the Congo River. Both eastern and western gorillas have two subspecies. A subspecies is a group that doesn't interbreed with any other group in the wild, although it possibly could if they were brought together in a zoo. Western gorillas live in hot, humid lowland areas, where the temperature rarely gets below 70 degrees Fahrenheit. They have by far the biggest population, although most of them live in remote areas, so it's hard to know for sure how many there are. There might be close to 100,000. A subspecies of western gorilla called cross river gorillas was once thought to be extinct. But in the 1980s, scientists discovered a tiny population hidden in a small area of highland forest on the border of Cameroon and Nigeria. No one is sure how many there are. There might be as few as 250. The biggest gorillas in the world are eastern lowland gorillas. Sometimes they're called growers gorillas. The males can reach 450 pounds and stand 6'5". Scientists estimate that their numbers have shrunk a lot in recent years. Most of these huge animals are clustered in one small region of the DRC. But this is an area that has been torn by civil war and is often patrolled by armed soldiers. It's a very dangerous place for wildlife researchers, and so it's hard to get an exact count of wildlife. There are now approximately 8,000 of these big animals. The other subspecies of eastern gorilla is the mountain gorilla. Approximately 1,000 of these shaggy animals remain, mostly in national parks in Rwanda and Uganda. Mountain gorillas have much thicker fur than gorillas that live in hotter parts of the rainforest. Gorilla gardeners. Like a lot of people, gorillas love to eat. Just like us, a gorilla will sometimes go, mmm, when savoring something really tasty. Many gorillas have a sweet tooth, and they love sticky, sugary fruit. And it turns out that's a really...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.